Hello, beautiful people. You to me. Welcome to another programming workout of mine. Today, we are trying to improve our knowledge in Angular, and we will be doing that for 30 minutes approximately, 5 minutes typing exercise, and then 25 minutes. It is third session in a row right now, so. Let's get into it. Hopefully, we will learn something. I'll start a timer. Does that then we still have 3 minutes to go? Six. Oh, really? I fucked up really badly. Oh no, I don't want to upgrade. I don't want to upgrade. I don't want to upgrade. We will go here. Improve. We finish that guy. So, closure. Okay. Here. That's function. Who's it for? Okay, this takes a minute, so whatever, fuck that. Fifty-six. Some accuracy, okay. So we'll continue in our journey here, and I want to see what we did in here. So this is our current progress, and now we will style it. So he shows this mass retail, blah blah blah. So we are. Oh wow, we are here. I thought we must be in like half or whatever. So let's go. Started the timer. Should be attractive. Should respond visually when users hover over and select arrow from the list. I will select something. Oh, yeah. Okay. In the first tutorial, you set basic styles for entire application and styles. That style didn't include styles for this list of heroes. We could add more styles to styles CSS and keep growing that style sheet as you add components. You may prefer instead to define private sheets for a specific component and keep everything a component needs. The code, the HTML, and the CSS together in one place. This approach makes it easier to reuse the component somewhere else and deliver the component's intended appearance, even if the global styles are different. You define private styles either in line in the add component styles array. Okay, so in the add component dot styles. Okay, so you mean I have this arrows component, and here is this guy. So this is the thing they are talking about. Maybe I don't have to have it on growing just blah 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 here. When the CLI generated the heroes component, it creates an empty heroes component dot CSS style sheet for the heroes component and pointed it to add component style URLs like this. Okay, so this is here, and this is what happened. Open the heroes component CSS and paste the private CSS styles. You'll find them in the final. Okay, so I will have a look. Bam. And we will go there. And in here we will have a look. Oh, thanks forever. Okay, so here somewhere is the CSS. Here. Okay, that's a lot of stuff. So we'll just paste it and, well, maybe we can have a little peek. Heroes. Heroes list. Heroes, however. Okay, so we have a heroes. That's like what? Heroes component HTML, and we have, okay, so heroes is this class, then we have batch. So heroes list, cursor pointer, oh, pointer. So, well, let's save this. This will reload, right? And then is hover, change the color, and yeah, okay. Looks nice, looks nice. And where's the, okay, so here, heroes LI, heroes LI, heroes is, how come this guy have different color than the other one? So we have the batch has different style than the heroes. Okay, I guess. Yeah, the span. The span, the batch. Heroes batch. So here is why it is different. Why it is different. Okay, cool. Cool, yo. Cool IO. Is that page taken? I'm sure it must be. Available. Cool.io is available for purchase. Coolio. For sale. Offer views. Bits. Oh. I'm not paying that. I'm not paying that. That's insane amount of money for that. That's insane. Is this one taken? It is. Or maybe it isn't. Okay, so I stole, so I did st I have I did steal the CSS, and so that's all nice and shit. Okay, and then we will have a master detail. When the user clicks in the hero, here and there, nothing's happened, right? You should display the selected hero's details and the bottom of the page. Bottom. Too big. This section. In this section, you'll listen for the hero item click event and update the hero detail. So, okay, so I go back to the template here, and then we in the LI we will put click equals and on select hero. And onSelect doesn't exist, so can I create method onSelect? Cool, that's awesome. This is really nice. I like. this guy. This is an example of Angular event binding syntax. So this means this one is like one way when you have like in this round parentheses. Parentheses around click tell Angular to listen to the li element click event. When the user clicks the li, Angular executes on select hero expression. In the next section, define onSelect method in hero's component to display the hero that was defined in the star ng4 expression. At the click, and so, okay, so I have that, and then. Okay, so we will define a selected hero. Selected hero. Type hero, cool, and we will say this dot selected hero equals hero, cool. Now, why you are red? You're not anymore. Okay, cool. You are still suppressed type the for current line. What's the problem? Expected call signature to have a type. Def. I. Okay, so maybe wait. This will be it. Yep. Okay, cool. So it. What was the weird error? To have type def type suppress. Oh, it even here says it might be void. Okay. Wait. So. So if we, well, now it will do nothing because if I click on it, it's clicked and nothing happens, right? I just changed the. Oh, it's reloading. It's reloading when I'm working with it. That's not fair. Okay, but I can print it out as well, right? So I can say console look this selected hero. Stupid fuck. And if I press it, it should hear output. It doesn't do. Okay, so this selected arrow dot name. Right. Now I save it. Now I reload it. And but still, it should print something, right? Why it didn't print anything? I would think. Oh fuck! I clicked something. Plugins not click here. The config. Oh fuck that. Oh, Dr. X, Anthony, Frederick. Now it works. So that was the name, and if I had it before, without it, it for some reason. Did not want to do what I wanted, so we will have. We'll have a look. Okay, now it works. I don't know what was it before. So What we did, this is the NG4. Now what we are learning that we can do the event thingy, right? So that was, maybe I don't need this, but it was this click in round brackets to in rounds parentheses bananas bananas. Do we have like Deli J bananas instead of parentheses? Curl syntax optional parentheses. It's not existing. Should be created. Should be created the plugin which will show bananas instead of parentheses. That's my thing. Nice color scheme, by the way, I like it. JetBrains 2.2. Really nice color scheme, I like it. Gray. Yeah, but fuck that, it's not important. It is not important. Detail selection. Currently, you have a list of the in the component template. On click, to click on a hero on the list and reveal details about that hero. It doesn't do shit. I did scroll too far. Add detail selection. Currently, you have a list in component templates. To click the hero on the list and reveal details about that hero. Oh, I still didn't have it. You need a section for the details to render in template. Add the following to hero's component HTML beneath the list section. So what do we have? Select the hero name, uppercase details, then we have ID. Label name, ng model selected here, placeholder name. Okay, cool. So, okay, so I guess I'll just, I don't wanna, I'll just paste it. That's the way how we roll right now. And maybe a space in here would be nice too, you know? I'm really so unhappy. I am unhappy. Okay, and it shits itself. There is some problem. Property name of undefined. Yeah. So selected hero is nothing, right? And cannot read name of undefined. What happened? When the app starts, that selector arrows is undefined by design. Yes. Binding expressions in the template that refer to properties of selected hero expressions, like selected hero.name, must fail because there is no selected hero. And it failed twice. In 7 in the HTML and then 7 failed twice. So, okay, so it was 7, now it is 8, and it was probably for this evaluation and then to uppercase evaluation that it is here twice, I believe. So, if I do this, save it and reload it, I should have only one error. Right. Oh, it's here still twice. Okay, maybe here as well. That's why. So I can, oh crap. I can put this here and take out this guy, save it, and reload. And now I will have it only once. Oh. No, it should. That should be it, right? Come on, come on. Angular compiler not loaded. Okay, so I say arrow. Save. Reload. I still got two. Okay, so this is uppercase, could not be found. And then pipe uppercase cannot be found. So it's mysterious. It's mysterious. Oh, fuck. E. Save. App updated. Recompiling. Yeah, go ahead. Pow, 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 pow. And I have gallery name undefined. Can't bind the ng4 off since it isn't. It's alpha. It's fucked up. It's fucked up. Okay, I'll leave it as it is. What happened? Blah blah blah. The fix: hide empty details with ngif. So, okay, wrap the hero detail and okay. So we will do exactly that, and that would be. Tag and if that will be star ngif ngif selected hero. Yeah, that's what we will do. Format, do absolutely nothing. So save, and maybe now it will be okay. It's recompiling. Okay, do you have some problem? Can't bind to ng4 off since it isn't a known property of li. Holy shit, what happened? If I comment all of this. If, oh crap. If I comment all of this and save it, that was the previous state, right? And that was working, I think. So what's wrong? What did I change? What did I do? UL LI can't bind to NG4 off since it isn't a known property of LI. What the hell? Let hero all heroes. And then I have to click. So. But the click was okay too. Unselect Hero. Holy crap. I really want to know what's the difference. If I go in here and have a look. Oh, that's the HTML heroes component. Okay, so H2 heroes UL li zero of that, then click on select heroes. What? Copy. Pasty. Savey. Worky. It is broken. And I don't know why. This will come again, okay. The fuck? I have no idea what happened. So here I'm using R2, final release. When I want to display a list of companies, I got this error. So what is the error? Where's the error? Oh, here's the error. Okay. And browser will import ng if it's the root module, twice the common module. Browser module. Okay, so we have that browser module. Will it change anything? So save it. Maybe this will reload. Doesn't work. So I'll remove this. Okay. Now I go to Heroes component and what the fuck? I have no freaking idea what just happened. Now it would be nice if I have some viewers which would be much more knowledgeable than I am. And tell me, like, oh, hey, you have this wrong. And I would say, oh, of course, there's missing semicolon or something. But that's not the reality of this evening. Okay, but that's not the only guy who had that problem. Maybe someone else, Barford, Ivy. Okay, what came to my mind is just to stop the thing in here and arrow S. Okay, so that's good. That it says more in here. It's private and only accessible within class. Okay, so that's good because now it actually tells me something more. If I go to arrows and I remove the private thingy, maybe that will fix the stuff. But what is not clear to me is it was working before. Okay, now it works. Why? What was the problem? That's weird. I still don't know how that happened. How should I understand it? Especially when it didn't work. So, let's say I will remove this. That and then I will go back and make this private again. I'll save it. And it works. But if I go, I still get the error in here, but it kind of works. So if I go here and I reverse this and save it, will it break up? Will it break? It works again, and I go to error. It says here error. And it even says like pretty nicely, like property arrows is private and only accessible within class arrows component. Okay. So if it's not accessible, I don't get how come it did work. That looks like a problem, or maybe I'm not. I don't understand something. Which I don't know which is which. Okay, so never mind. We had the detail in here which I can uncomment. Maybe I can. I cannot. So uncomment, save, and now what? No, there's nothing, but when I press this, hey, oof. This one did not change. This one didn't change. Frederick Christensen. But the programmer. You see, this thing didn't change. Okay. Oh well, while we did fix it, that's good. And the next thing, therefore, to do. I mean, what we did last? It was master detail. Yeah, we did that. And component, what it. Work styles of selected guy. Final color, okay. Dun dun dun. Add a click event handler. Add details section. We did that. After the browser refreshes, the application is broken. Open the browser developer tools and look in the console. Yeah, so we did that. Fix, hide, empty details. Yeah, so that's the last thing we were doing, and then it broke for some reason. And after the browser refreshes, list of names reappears. The details area is blank. What? The NGF in here. The list of names reappears. The details area is blank. A hero in the list of heroes and the details appear. The app seems to be working again. Why it works? When it has different colors. Why it works? When selected hero is undefined, the NGF removes the hero detail from the DOM. There are no selected hero bindings to consider when the user picks hero. Selected hero has a value, and NGF puts the hero detail into the DOM. Style selected hero. So this will be the next thing to do. So I will make a note what to do next. It will be this. Style the selected hero. Save, yes. So we are tiny bit over the time limit. Which means we are done with the third programming workout today. Very well, me. And we'll continue tomorrow, I guess. So, bye.